Alright, let's go do the fun part. Weird. With that lighting. Why did this wall light up all of a sudden? Huh. We'll just do one at a time for now. So, at some point we'll have to go get one more good batch of cattails. I'll get the roots too, so we can try to get the pond filled in the rest of the way. We're about two-thirds of the way done. Copper plate, please. And need another hammer. All right, so let's put one in here. And I think in here for the next one. Whoops. Thank you. Alright, yay! I can just find another quartz field and get, what, three more? Then we'll have our interior torchless. Alright, what next? Yeah, with prospecting, it's just a matter of perseverance and triangulation. Once you know how to check various directions and follow the seams, follow the numbers up and down. A little harder when you're playing Wilderness Survival with no map. But if you're playing with a map, I do recommend the VS Prospector info somebody mentioned in chat. Very helpful. Let's see. I'm almost done with my knife, but I've got to back up. I'm almost done with my hammer. I definitely need to get that fixed. Being a little worried about the amount of copper we've got for things I want to get done. All right, new hammer, new pickaxe, and a new pro pick. That'll give us three of everything except for the hammer. I might actually do just two hammers. Yeah, two hammers and one pro pick. Oops. Pro picks are actually in pretty good shape. Yeah, two hammers and a an ingot, I think. We're good on the other tools. Picked up quite a bit more grain to make bread and pies out of while we were out. Yeah, basically need a little bit of everything. Let's finish that and that. Yeah, I should probably harvest some more berries from my local berry patch. Use the grain I've got for fruit pies. Or I need to get some jam done. We're probably going to be due for another storm here pretty soon. think that will probably be too late. We'll have to reheat that, but that's fine. Actually, let it keep some residual heat. Maybe we'll be able to do it. I'm willing to sacrifice one more coal. Bismuth Knight. Yeah, that's pretty much the big thing I need to be doing. Need to be out and about getting maybe it's time to make a sword. That way I have some kind of a weapon in case I get jumped by something. I don't want to carry 6 spears around with me while I'm out running around the world. That gets messy with my inventory constantly full. Yeah, we'll be okay now. We'll be able to pour that second one. Hey, there's the storm. All right. Oof. Interesting. This thing be made in one ingot? Am I gonna have enough? It's gonna be pretty close. I need 4 more over there. Not a lot of wiggle room on this one. Ah, I cooled down too much. Damn it. I'm gonna go through so much more than I wanted to. Mining speed, wood 2.2, leaves 1.6, huh? All right, I got that round done, so we got a brand new hammer, almost brand new, with a backup coming. We've got a melee weapon, put that there. Alright, don't need to babysit any of this. How the crops doing? 9 out of 9. Peanuts. All right, last thing is the peanuts, one stage to go. Time to dig this up. I can wait. No hurry on it. We'll hope we get enough for another full row. That's a lot of spelt grain. Oh boy. Yeah, I got almost no crops in the pea nutrient category. Oops. Lots of N, lots of K, mostly because of all the flax. And only a couple of P. All right, however. So that's what I've got to make sure I've got warm clothes through the winter. Terrible timing on the storm again. Gonna pretty much ruin the entire day. Crap. How are we doing in here? Oh yeah. That's my overflow barrel. Come on. To chop them up first, break a knife. Point 2 out of 4.5 days, so close. First batch of leather. All right, we're done with leather processing. 2.5, huh? I guess we will grind out some limestone while we wait. Everybody's favorite viewing activity. That's another barrel's worth. Like to get one more barrel's worth whenever. It'll be a little while before we have enough hides to do another batch anyway. Let's see. Now that we've got a second batch of 8 and 8 on the way, this will get my backpacks done and leave some extra. This plus the extra will be enough for most anything else I want to do, I think. I don't need a huge amount of leather. All right, we gotta go get in the hole. Let's grab some food, and that's pretty much it. Alright, here we're gonna squat. For the next 10 minutes or so, once the storm starts, I'm gonna take a quick AFK. Well, it'll be a not so quick AFK. I'll be gone a few minutes at least, because I can't do anything while the storm's going on. So I'll take this opportunity to go get something to drink and stretch the legs and all that good stuff. I'll be back with you in just a few. Thank you. Well, it's still going on. 47%, man. These things are long. The only thing I don't like about trying to play Iron Man, these heavy storms that you can't do anything about for extended periods of time. Not hearing any bad guys. What'd you do with them while I was gone? So, here's why I'm not making a sling, but somebody keeps mentioning. But you get down with your bad sling self on your improviser trait, dude. I forget which of the character class names gets the improviser trait. Is it the Blackguard? I don't think they mention the class traits in game. Malefactor, yeah. That's the one. Where does it say the name of the ore that you mine or you prospect? I can't remember the names of all of them, and I can never find it in here. I know there's like cassiterite. Twenty pieces smelt into one ting ingot. And units of 10. Rare material phyllite. A lot of tin ore versions. Cassiterite in all of them, though. All right, we'll stay out of those menus so time actually progresses. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to change the rules of how I deal with the storms. It's just so boring. It's not entertaining for me or for you folks to watch. So I think for the sake of entertainment value, I'm just gonna have to change my rules of Iron Man during the storms so I can be out and about trying to kill things or something. It's probably what I'll do with the next run. I just got to be so hyper cautious if I'm trying to play true Iron Man that I can't afford to be out trying to kill anything or even experimenting with combat to see what kind of armor and weapon combos can stay alive during a heavy storm. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the storm implementation. It wouldn't be so bad if they didn't have double-headed drifters and nightmare drifters on day three. I mean, I'd be fine with it if it was surface drifters in the first weeks of the storms, and then they escalate as time goes by and new, more dangerous versions are added at various quantities. Until eventually, after 2 or 3 years in the world, you're getting lots of nightmare and double-headed drifters. But that's not the way it works. It's just, let's just randomly drop double-headed drifters right on top of the player on day three and insta-kill them. Which, I mean, if you're not playing Iron Man, I guess no big deal. But anybody wanting to try to play Iron Man is just totally screwed by that kind of system. All right. Goodbye block. Goodbye torch. Yeah, they blew up my entire day. Actually, I should do another exterior torch replacement before I forget. Alright, so one peanut plant is the sole remaining crop. We're not going to do anything with either of the two fields for now. We're going to let them just lie and regain nutrients over time till next spring. My plan is to put two more fields up. And that will probably do it. The only other thing I could work on, and I'm not sure I really want to, is getting the animals in and penned up. I just really, really don't like doing it. I don't find much value out of the effort. So we'll see. First, I've got to get progressing along the metal pathways. I got to get a bronze secured. That's the number one goal currently. How are you guys doing? Am I going to get one more harvest out of you guys? Oh, populated. Empty, empty, empty. Yeah, they haven't been moving much. Oh, we got a few populated. I might get one more good harvest out of them. I don't remember when the bees stopped producing. Okay. Okay on the food. Nothing's gonna go bad. I got tons of grain to process into bread or whatever. I've got berries that might not be available anymore. Uh-oh. Nope, they're ripe. Can't see them in the dark. Yeah, there's quite a few berries in here. So I could do a big berry pick and try to make as much jam as possible. Or pies, but the pies will go bad before I ever get them eaten, so... How long does the jam last? 6.3 years. That's enough time. So yeah, we might go on a jelly spree, use up our honey. And fruit, big old batch of jelly over in the corner here. Then we'll leave the grain as is, because we can make bread whenever we need to if we just leave the grain alone. So the grain is good for 5 years. So as needed, I can just grab the bucket of water and turn it into bread, and we can bake up another batch of bread whenever. So yeah, maybe I'll dump some of this downstairs for long-term storage. Same with this. Only 2.6 years, huh? You're gonna make me put it in the clay vessel? Which I don't have space for? Yeah. You're gonna make me put it in there to store it. I kinda stopped making these things. Maybe I'll have to do a couple of them just to hold the grain for an extended period of time. That 0.13 perish speed is pretty awesome. All right, we'll leave this alone for the moment. I got more time-sensitive stuff to take care of. Actually, I don't. It's 2100. Been a little while since I made storage vessels. Or napped or formed clay. Go refresh my peat supply as well. That we can do in the dark.